Optionals are also necessary for downcasting in Swift. Here's what I mean by downcasting. Occasionally, objects are labeled as members of a particular class, but can also act as a member of a subclass. To downcast is to cast such an object as an instance of its subclass. You'll see a lot of downcasting with optionals when you start interacting with classes like UI Storyboard and the App Delegate. But let's start with a simpler example. Here we have a beverage class with two subclasses, hot drink and cold drink. We also have an array of beverages. Because there are both hot drinks and cold drinks in this array, the array must be of class beverage. There are no mixed type arrays in Swift. Let's say we wanted to loop through the array of beverages and generate a message that will offer each of the drink choices. When we loop through the array, each item will be treated as a beverage. But we really want our message to be more specific than that. It would be better if we could cast a beverage as a hot drink or a cold drink before offering a drink to a guest. Now, there are two points here I'd like you to remember. First, focus on this piece of code here. When we grab a drink from the array, we don't know whether it can be cast to a cold drink or not, so we use an optional cast with an as question mark, also known as a typecast operator. By casting the item from the array as an optional cold drink, we're saying this item could be a cold drink, or it could be nil. Here's the second point I'd like you to remember. As we know, optionals can't be used until they're unwrapped. So if you use the as question mark typecast operator, you also have some unwrapping to do. Just like we've done previously with other optionals, we can use if-let. Remember that the if-let construction checks to see if an optional has a value. If it does have a value, this code gets executed, and we can use cold drink in our message. If it doesn't have a value, the else block is executed, and the beverage is cast as a hot drink. And here in the sidebar, we can see those custom messages. But let's not forget about the exclamation points. Although they are risky, they can also be convenient in cases where we're confident about the identity of the object being downcast. Let's say we're a coffee shop. We only serve hot coffee, but for some reason, a method from an Apple library is returning an array of items of class beverage. If we never deal in cold drinks, we might boldly downcast beverages to hot drinks using as exclamation point. As we know, optionals with exclamation points automatically unwrap, so our downcasting work is done. No if-let required.